Hi there, this week is Computer Science Education Week. Last year, Code.org started a movement called the Hour of Code to promote computer science. The main goals of the week is to increase the interests of women and students in the field of computer science. This year, I'll be running a competition in celebration of the week starting from today, the 8th of December 2014, and ending on the 14th of December 2014. There will be four different sections: an easy section for those who have never written code before, a medium section for those who have a beginner understanding of programming, and an advanced section for those with a firm understanding of programming, as well as a fourth section called Teach, which I'll talk about in a little bit. All code will be in the programming language Python, which you can download for free at python.org. All provided skeleton code will be in the description of this video on YouTube. Okay, so let's get into the sections. Easy, for those with no experience. If you have never done any programming in your life, then this is the challenge for you. You are required to make a program that allows you to play paper, scissors, rock against the computer. For this, you'll need to learn the basics of programming, either with the aid of watching or reading tutorials on how to write beginner programs, or with the help of a friend that does know how to program. I have a Python 3 beginner series on my YouTube if you are unsure where to find a tutorial. You will only need to know how to output text onto the screen, input text into the program, and how to have the computer make decisions with the if code. There will be an easy skeleton code file provided that will have comments and hints at how to build your program, as well as I will provide the code to get a random choice from the computer. Prizes will be given out to 10 submissions who show that they have tried their best either with a working program or a non-working program. Leave comments on what your code does, what you had trouble with, and what you wish you knew when you started for extra points. Medium, for those with a basic understanding. The medium challenge is to create a noughts and crosses game in the command line. The game can just be a turn-based two-player game. First person enters their choice, second person enters their choice. Or, if you wish, you can add your own computer AI to play against you. I strongly encourage you to leave lines of code in that you tried but didn't work out, and just comment them out. Try to comment what blocks of code are doing, so I can see that you understand what you are doing and you didn't copy-paste. Two prizes will be giving out for entries that work and show progression or commenting, as well as a third prize for an entry with a computer AI. Advanced, for those with a firm understanding. The challenge for you is to sort a large list of integers from highest to lowest without borrowing or using anyone else's code. Problem solve this one yourself. I'll provide the skeleton file that has all of the timing code and program setup. You only need to write the sort function. The advanced challenge will be scored on how fast your sort function works, and the quality of the commenting and progress. Once again, I strongly encourage you to leave lines of code in that you have tried but didn't work out, and just comment them out. While the fastest legitimate entry will get a prize, entries that show progression will also go into the running. If the last three challenges are things that you have done before, then you can still be in for a prize. We have Teach, for any understanding. Convince a person who has never done any programming before to attempt the easy section. This could be a parent, partner, spouse, or friend. Teach them the basics of Python, either with the aid of tutorials or with your own knowledge. After they have an understanding of getting input, output, and if statements, have them attempt the paper, scissors, rock. Help explain the process of how to go about implementing the game on a computer. Getting the random number will be in the skeleton file, but you can explain how to get the random number if you wish. Now for the rules and submission. The rules are pretty simple. Don't steal anyone else's code. Don't ask someone to write the code for you. We are here to learn, remember, and only one submission per person. I'm very flexible on how you can give me your final code. You can send the raw code to me over YouTube, Twitter at DrapsTV, or Google Plus private message. You can send me a Dropbox or share site link via the private message as well. You can also use a pastebin.com link to submit also. If you want to post your submission in the comment section of YouTube, make sure you start your comment with CSEW14. This will allow me to filter out your posts so only you and I can see the submission, and no one else can steal your entry. If you are entering the Teach section, have the person you are teaching put your YouTube or Twitter ID at the top of their code file or in the message they send me. All of this will be in the description. Remember, you have until the end of December 14th to get your submission to me. Prizes. Everyone loves prizes. A little motivation never hurt anyone. I don't have much money, but I've purchased a bunch of Steam keys for an assortment of different games. Some of these games include The Ship, I believe this is a pack that contains a spare copy for a friend, Hard Reset, which is a first-person action shooter, Space Pirates and Zombies, or SPAZ for short, which is a top-down spaceship RPG, Hydrophobia Prophecy, which is a single-player shooter set in a water-flooded facility, Legendary, an action first-person shooter with slight horror elements, Velvet Assassin, which is a stealth action-based game about a female spy, and many more. On December 15th or 16th, depending on the entries, I will personally message you if you have won a prize through the YouTube private message system if you have submitted via YouTube, or if you submitted via Twitter private message, I'll message you there. Okay, that's it for this video. Scroll down to the description and get started. I encourage you all to get someone you know to try at least an hour of code for Computer Science Education Week. If you are new here, consider checking out some of my other videos on my channel. If you enjoy it and want to see more, subscribe. Maybe my channel isn't your thing, but you have a friend that may like it. I'd love if you could send them here. If you have any questions, feel free to leave them in the comments or send them to me on Twitter. I want to wish you all the best of luck. Thanks for watching.